Research and innovation can have a positive impact on society. But there can be a gap between research and society. People are protesting. They don't think their views are being heard. They believe they're being ignored in the development of new research that affects them. It's making the researchers think if they could have done things differently. And with headlines being made, it's making people angry. So much so that the policymaker is getting questions about it all. "We need this research," she says. "I need to speak with the professor and the people who are affected by this research." She sets up a meeting. There's the policymaker, the researcher, the civil society representative, and the research funder. They each clarify their role. The researcher says she wants to contribute to new knowledge and open the way to innovation. The civil society representative says that he represents citizens' interests and wants to make sure that their voice is heard. The funder explains that they run a major research funding program and that because it's public money, they are accountable to citizens. The policymaker says that she has responsibility for ensuring that research contributes to our economic growth and benefits society. Each of these types of stakeholders have a key role to play in research. Let's take a quick look at the European situation. Only 1 in 4 EU-funded collaborative research projects involves civil society organisations. Evidence has shown that CSO involvement works best within European projects when they play a central role within the project, acting as the link between the research project on the one hand and a part of society on the other. For instance, in the health sector, CSOs may recruit patients that test or assess a new treatment or product. CSOs also perform a vital role in translating complex research jargon into something more accessible and help foster participation in the project. So, the meeting goes on and everyone has their say. The researcher introduces their design of the robot. The patient representative explains the reactions of patients and their families. The policymaker emphasizes what they had originally planned to achieve from this research program. And the funder outlines ways that this research could be realized. Working together can bridge the gap between research and society. As a result of this success, each of these groups vowed to better collaborate within research programs to ensure civil society involvement. The researcher says she will get down to earth and involve citizens. The CSO representative says he will take the initiative and reach out to researchers. The policymaker says she will rethink scientific excellence to involve citizens. And the funder says that he will give citizens a voice in shaping the research agenda. All of these different stakeholders need to work together on a regular basis to make this happen. Civil society engagement in research and innovation is not just about improving public support for research, it's about actually improving the research itself. If you want to know more, go to www.consider-project.eu.